The music really grabs you. Like the film, it's extremely dramatic. It just kind of takes you in.
The music is more emotional, the words are all in another language, so it's not, no one's going to be listening to the words saying, oh, I can hear the story from the words. You know, the story is all in the movie.
The film itself, being a critically acclaimed film, and from an artistic perspective, is just mesmerizing when you look at what they've done from a film perspective. And then you couple that with music that varies from being profoundly moving and powerful to ethereal. And you can't help but be drawn in by this and mesmerized by this film.
I think of this as kind of one of those high class events. You always look back at like the high roaring like Art Deco era of the 1920s, especially being from the Detroit area and all the architecture that's kind of a remnant from that time. This is another kind of captured piece of that time that's been brought into the present.
I feel that it's one of the most unique performances that the chorale has done.
When I heard about what we were doing this, I looked it up and I fell in love instantly. And I've easily listened to the soundtrack probably over 200 times. I just listen to it every night and it's just so beautifully done.
When we got the score and started learning the music for it, it was just awesome. It's just an awesome piece.
I was fortunate enough to do it in 2009. And I remember the emotions and the feelings and the prep for it the last time, and I was just really excited to do it again.
The chorale and the musicians played the role that a piano would have done in the old houses playing silent movies. We are the voice and the voices of this light that was Joan of Arc.
It's a really interesting experience, you know, being able to take this piece out of time and bring it back into the modern day.
It's something that you can't walk out or walk away from without really feeling moved.